So the molecule we work on plays a central role in the activation of T cells, and we really believe that being able to understand how this molecule works will help us in the future to use it for cure of diseases. The processes we found really explain how T cells can be so sensitive yet very, very specific. So they only recognize threats and not your own body.
T cells, you have to imagine them as the police of your body. So whenever you have a bacteria infecting you, the T cells are the one which actually protect you. So they're circling the body, and whenever there's a problem, they fight the pathogen or help you not to get sick.
In our recent studies, we have found that the process by which T cells are activated is much more fluid than thought before. And instead of being a static process where molecules assemble within a T cell, it is actually more comparable to a train station where molecules come really frequently, and the time they stay and the time they leave actually decides over the outcome of the immune response. The molecule that we work on, sub-70, has actually been indicated in this kind of interaction, and we can really show that the shape of the molecule affects how this protein interacts with others.
So the interesting thing is that we found a new mechanism how this sub-70 molecule is activated, and this distinguished this molecule from other molecules that are very similar. So we can use this knowledge now in order to develop new therapies.
We want to understand how other molecules within T cells work and if they use similar pathways, and the final goal that we have is really to modulate the way they respond. So going back to the train analogies, we basically want to determine when a train arrives, when a train leaves, and how long it stays in the station. T cells are involved in many diseases, so our findings help us to understand T cell responses better and possibly help us in the future to cure diseases using our own immune system.